Can you talk about a specific poem of yours that maybe one that you read in the companion program? I'm thinking of The Way from your selected poems,
Okay,
Vale.
yeah. Well, the way is sort of an example of what I was talking about when I talked about my notational process and about making notes in a notebook about things I hear or see and then combining those notes later into a poem. So the way begins, card in pew pocket announces, I am here. You were asking me about religion. Well, that actually, well, pew pocket suggests I was in a church listening to a musical program, and I pulled out a flyer, a handout that was in the pew pocket, and it said, I am here. And I mean, obviously that's very ambiguous. I was there, but I don't think the I was supposed to be me. I think it was supposed supposed to be Jesus. So there was a question of, location. And which is, those prepositions are always tricky, and the pronouns are tricky. So I pulled that out. And then the second stanza, I made only one statement because of a bad winter, sounds as if the first speaker were talking, the person who said, I am here, which, might have been Jesus given the context. But in fact, those lines were quoted from probably insane person that I overheard speaking in a cafe. And then the next couple lines, Greece is the word, Greece is the way I am feeling, you probably recognize as lyrics from the song Greece in the musical. And then the next, real life emergencies or flubbing behind the scenes. I got that from the TV Guide, and those were sort of proto-reality TV show descriptions from some years back, but when, reality TV started to take off and it seemed really intimate, I guess still does, to see somebody flubbing behind the scenes, a view into the interiority of the person as produced by, Hollywood. So the first half of the poem are really different voices, different snippets of my world juxtaposed. And then the second half of the poem, as a child I was abandoned in a story made of trees, etc., is not found language and is a sort of version, I guess, of my experience of being read to as a child. So it is more personal or, in a coded way, autobiographical. So I'm starting out with the found language, which announces the personal, I am here. And but isn't in fact me speaking. And then in the second half, I'm putting myself speaking or my experience as a child sort of up in contact with that more alienated language.
How about the line breaks in that poem? What makes you break a line in one place versus the other?
Well, that's a good question. That's something that I often, puzzle about and wonder if I do the best job at. Sometimes I do it for sound reasons, for rhythm reasons. Sometimes I do it to sort of build up a certain suspense. I don't like it when you can really see what's coming. If you can get any kind of surprise into the next line, I think that's best. I think I started writing in really short lines when I was a young beginning poet. Oddly, because my mother did read poems to me when I was a child. She had an anthology of poems for kids, and a lot of them, of course, were in iambic pentameter. And I really kind of got that into my head, and it was hard to get it out. And so when I first started to write, I was writing it sort of unconsciously, almost in regular meters, and I wanted to break that up, since I was reading Pound and Williams. And so I started to write in shorter lines. And now once in a while not that often, but once in a while I try longer lines, and I can do it now without suddenly being iambic. But that was why I went to the shorter lines, I think. But anyway, to reiterate, I'm not always sure, but when I think it works best, it can create some kind of double meaning or suspense or some such.